The purpose of the exercise was to have you generate some log messages and to have you look them up in Journal D and in Syslog as well. So the exercise asks to log in as user Caroline and as user Caroline to do an SU and just hit enter on the password. That should generate a log event somewhere. So let's exit back to a root shell and let's see if we can find what exactly it has done. The first place could be a tail on var log secure. Var log secure is the default location where the rsyslog auth-priv facility is sending its messages to. And what we can see here is that there has been happening something for a user Caroline, but we cannot see exactly what it has done. So the amount of information is limited and not very detailed. The alternative would be to use journalctl_com. _com is a very useful option with journalctl because it looks in the log for a specific command that you specify as an argument here. And there you can see everything that has been logged by the su command. It can even be better if you add -o verbose, which gives you the famous verbose information that specifies the entire environment and really gives a lot of information that may help finding out what exactly went wrong. So this should have demonstrated that journalctl is really a big step forward in getting the appropriate information from the log files. The next question was to configure log rotate to keep log files for a month while keeping the last six log files. So if you go to the etc logrotate.conf file, you can see here monthly and rotate six. That would do the job. After doing it, there's no need to restart any service because log rotate is launched as a cron job. And cron will automatically pick it up the next time that log rotate will be running.